really where we're at today. We're in the, what some people say is the haunted jailhouse from 1910 in Globe, Arizona. And one of the most incredible things happened in this jail. An inmate was assassinated by a gun fired from the courthouse. It's an incredible story, and I know you're gonna wanna stay around. We don't get spooked out. Where's James? James! We're sending James to the third floor. It's gonna be awesome for us. Not moving much for him. You know, right now, I'm on the third floor of the jailhouse going into the courtroom. Now, on this bridge is where the convicts would be taken after they got sentenced back to the jailhouse right over here. Now, on one day, a convict decided, you know what? He didn't want to have to do his time. So what he did was, he jumped over this very railing to his death, three stories down. Would somebody please come out of one of these cells here? Would somebody please come out? I'm gonna go downstairs. And would somebody please walk across the glass and go over to that other office if you're up here? Or even come down the stairs? And let us know you're here. We appreciate it.
I would have done it on purpose.
phones down.
That's scary, dude. This is scary.
Dude, you gotta do it. Go.
Okay. This is so scary, man. Oh my God. Oh my God.
You won't believe what we got ourselves into this time. Or you might. Got an entrance after hours to one of the most incredible jails in the Southwest. And we're in a town called Globe. And I'm telling you what, if there was ever a ghost or a creepy feeling, we've already got James pretty creeped out, but what we're gonna do tonight, and don't say a word, is we're sending James. Did you hear that? To the third floor by himself. This has been an incredible place. So let's talk a little bit about the story in the cell that I'm in right now. I'm in the very cell of a gentleman named Kingsley Oles. Now, what Kingsley did was unheard of. He drowned two young girls and was put into this cell right here in that exact bed. And he would call the jailers at night and tell them that he was being haunted by those two little girls, even though he said he didn't do it, right? And one of the things that happened that was the most incredible thing that you're ever going to hear is that he was assassinated in this very building. And the most amazing thing is, the deadly shot didn't come within this building. Now we're on the second floor, right? So where could anyone have possibly taken a high-powered rifle and aimed it right at Kingsley's head? And guess what? When the shots rang out, Kingsley was no more. Now, the most incredible thing in this very cell is where he met his maker. And that fateful bullet came from the courthouse. So, that fateful night, shots rang out from one of those windows right there and went directly into that cell
right there. Through that window.
Through that window and killed him in his bed. And they never caught him. How can that be? How can you not catch? This is the courthouse, okay? This is not like some abandoned structure. I mean, this was the courthouse. And somebody came into the courthouse, fired a rifle shot across right here. Over to that window there. How can that even happen? You know, this whole town is full of death and destruction. And, you know, I mean, they had one bathroom to 28 inmates, right? And they had, that's unheard of. And, you know, I guess, you know, jail life wasn't a pleasant one.
And I'm sure this structure here, as we're looking at on this crosswalk. Now, an inmate we talked about earlier jumped to his death right down here. Went face first, so I'm sure that this building is definitely haunted as well. Who knows what walks these halls at night? James swore that that a shadow figure was in there. And, I can see that. I can definitely see that. But, this whole building has been filled with history. And, look at this light back here. Might have been that pole. I thought something came back behind me. I was sure of it, and now it was that pole. So, man, I love this place. I used to do a lot more of this kind of stuff, and we quit doing it. And there's so much negative energy you can take. There's only so much negative energy. There gets to be a point where eventually, what happens is that all the negative energy kind of gets to you. I mean, it's almost like a it just starts to build up on you, and you kind of need to get a shower from it. I know that probably sounds bizarre, but if you ever done this stuff, you get this feeling that, man, all of a sudden there's a heavy, it's like a heavy coat on you. And that's one thing about some of the guys that do this stuff, like the Ghost Adventure guys and some of those guys that are out there that do this work all the time, is, man, it's extremely difficult. Because what's difficult about it is emotionally, it's very draining. It really is. And, because something's there. You don't know exactly what it is. You don't always see ghosts and stuff like that. But I'll be real curious to see if we see anything come across this gate. I'm going to summons out and see if anybody comes down this other. Oh, the vibe in here has got really weird. The vibe in that room has got really weird. But let's look up here. Let's put the camera up there, and then let's see if we can find something that goes across. Would somebody please come out of one of these cells here? Would somebody please come out? I'm gonna go downstairs, and would somebody please walk across the glass and go over in that other office if you're up here? Or even come down the stairs? And let us know you're here. We appreciate it. What the? What the hell was that? Come on, what was that? I'm not bullshitting. I thought maybe it was you. Is it a cat? Oh, it was clear up here. I couldn't tell from downstairs or upstairs.
I thought it was. Anything when you're up here? That scared the shit out of me.
No. Do me a favor, walk
with the camera. Around the outside, have you done that?
Yes.
Do it again. Like right now. All right. Go slow. James is coming in. They seem to like you better.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to go up there with him and make sure that he finds his way. And we're going to see what this is like. So let's go down. Oh, these are dark. Let's pick a good one.
This place is terrible.
This one's evil.
tell this is the evil one here.
This really is.
You can't hardly see in here, though. Why don't you just sit on one of them benches?
This is terrifying.
Now, if there's anyone that wants to speak, you know, James used to be a prison guard. And he hates inmates. And I just didn't know if you knew that or not. I mean, he absolutely hates inmates. I mean, he told me that anybody that ever get thrown in jail would have no business even living. Should just kill yourself. So, you know, if you would like to come in and talk to James, he's going to be here for a while. The hell was that?
Dude, not cool. Jeff.
Stay over here. Till I come in.
Oh, dude. This is absolutely terrifying.
Talk to him. They like to be talked to. He's upstairs.
It is so scary in here. This is probably one of the scariest things I've ever done. We've combined two of my bigger fears, one being in jail. Incarceration of any sort, as well as the possibility of it being haunted jail. This place is definitely making some noises. More than anything, it's just this sense of a presence that I really don't like right now. Like, I really don't want to start talking to them because I don't want to upset any possible spirits or such. Especially those in a jail. You gotta be kidding me. So something definitely just touched me. I am leaving now. As fast as I can. Cause I'm not doing that. Okay.
My name is Kelly. I am with the historic 1910 Gila County Jail here in Globe, Arizona. The Globe Jail ran from 1910 till 1981. It was always fully occupied with 28 inmates per floor to one toilet. There was a women's section here as well, up on the third level. Not very many women did much time in here, so they used it as an overflow section for the men. And even juveniles were in here as well. One of the infamous stories about a man by the name of Kingsley Olds, who supposedly murdered the two little girls out at Horseshoe Bend, he did some time in here, about 24 hours maybe, before he was shot from the connecting courthouse across the way, straight into his cell through two sets of bars and straight to his head, and he died immediately. So nobody knows if the story, if he really did kill those little girls. Dead men tell no tales, so nobody will ever know. He did come alert to where he said he saw the visions of the lost girls after they were murdered, that their spirits came and they were anxiously awaiting supposedly his arrival, and then after that he was killed. One shot to his head and he was gone. I've been doing the jail tours here for quite some time now, and when I'm in here by myself, On our second Saturdays is when we usually do them. I'm sitting in our video room at the old deputy sheriff's office, which is now our video room. And I was sitting in there one on a Saturday, and I kept hearing this music coming from the back of the jail here on the lower level cells. And it was called Sunshine in the Valley. Well, I kept playing the same chorus over and over, and I thought, gosh, that's just kind of weird, you know. Where's this coming from? Well, I knew there was a funeral next door. So I looked at the window thinking, well, surely they're not playing their music that loud. The funeral was over with. I know the Performing Arts Center, there was some young kids in the alleyway practicing plays or whatever. Oh, it's probably coming from there. Well, they were done practicing. Okay, so the second I would step over the first floor threshold of the cells, it would stop. The second I'd get back to the video room, it'd start again. But it was, 1 minute it was a woman singing, and then the next it was a man singing it. Finally, it became a game, and then I was getting really nervous, and then I was getting mad, because when I get scared, I get mad. So when I finally made it over the threshold, it didn't stop. It's like I finally caught him. I beat, you know, won this one. So I got over to the old, it's an old hi-fi stereo. Okay, it was the record. I just kept, something was malfunctioning with the record, okay? Well, I'd go to switch the lever off. It's already off. But the record's playing, the needle's on the record. Okay, well, there's, it's old, you know, vintage stereo. Something has got to be wrong with the cord that you plug it into. So I look around for the cord to unplug it. Here is the cord, and the song is still playing. It was not plugged in, but the song was playing. So I just ran and said, goodbye, I'm leaving now, and you guys can have your song and listen to it and enjoy it, but I am out of here. I just couldn't understand. I don't know what happened.
You know, this story is so creepy, right? The story about Mr. Olds, right? So he comes back into the jail, and he's got a gunshot right here, and he can't talk at all. And I mean, did he do it? Did he not do it? You know, it's really hard to tell that he, if he did it or not, right? Because dead men tell no tales.